What's up, guys? Mark here. Today, I'm gonna be chefing up some silver carp again.
Yeah, I had went to the farmer's market the other day,
and the silver carp there was really, really fresh. So. And today I'm gonna chef it up. So yeah, let's go. So today this is what we're cooking.
Silver carp head.
So yeah, like two videos ago, I had cooked the silver carp head and it was so good. Like so good. And yeah, I went to the farmer's market the other day and this one, it was really fresh. You could tell it was really fresh. So I bought it right away. $1 a pound for the fish head. So this is 3 pounds. So this is about $3 for a lot of meat. Like there's a lot of meat in this. And yeah, it was really fresh. So to tell if a fish is fresh, first you gotta look at the eyes. See that these are very clear and not sunken in, like not like shriveled in at all and very clear. That's how you know it's pretty fresh. And then the next thing, see how it's shiny like that? If it still has slime on it, that's also how you know it's pretty fresh. When fish swim in the water, they got this slime on them to help them swim faster inside the water. So as time goes on, after a fish dies, the slime starts to, like, I don't know, disintegrate or something. So that's how you tell if a fish is fresh or not. The eyes and then the slime. And then the next thing, the third thing you could look at is the gills. So if you, the gill flap, push this thing up right here. See how they're very red? When fish are alive, their gills are red like this. But as time goes on, after they die, the gills will start to turn brown. So that's also how you tell if the fish is fresh or not. Eyes, slime, gills. Yeah, so this is the silver carp or the Asian carp. These are the infamous fish that jump out of the water when they get scared by like boat engines.
Getting wet.
So yeah, these fish are taking up a lot of the waterways, but they are very good. So everyone should try these fish at one point in their lives. So yeah, so first things first, we're gonna take the gills out. All right, you're gonna make a cut right here and go all the way through. And then also, the silver carp are notorious for getting really, really, really big. And one reason they get so big is because of these, their gills. So they're filter feeders and they eat a lot of plankton and algae. And on their gills, there's these little things called gill rakers. And these collect the algae and plankton in the water, like as they swim. So basically eating is a pretty passive process. Like they just eat. So they just keep eating. And that's why they get so big so fast. It's their gill rakers. All right. The gills come out pretty easy. You just gotta grip them and they just come right out. So you see how red these gills are? That's how you know it's a fresh fish. Throw these away. These are not edible. Like pretty much every part of the fish besides the gills is edible. All right, we're gonna clean it now. I think this is actually the heart right here. Since this fish was pretty fresh, we're gonna eat this one too. So they say they are filter feeders, but they do have these. These are called pharyngeal teeth, and these crush prey. Like common carp, they have these teeth in there, the back of their mouths as well, because they eat a lot of like crustaceans, like crawfish and stuff like that. But yeah, check that out. They got some teeth. Like some actual teeth.
Okay.
Alright, nice and clean in there. Alright, so these are the collars right here. Now we're gonna remove these collars off. One collar. Alright. Got the second collar. Alright. We're gonna trim the stomach lining off of it. It's got a bitter taste. Alright, this one's good. And now this one. Got your two collars. All right, now we're gonna split this carp head in half so it'll fit better in the pan. Okay. All right, so these got quite a bit of blood in them still, and that's gonna give it a fishy taste. So I'm gonna blanch them really quick just to get rid of the unwanted fishy taste. All right, that's good. All right, now we're gonna make the sauce. We're gonna get 1.5 cups of sake. All right. 1.5 cups of water. 2 tablespoons of soy sauce. Got the brand new bottle. Yes. Each. Need. Yes. 1 tablespoon of sugar. Onion powder. And then I do still have some of those silver carp fillets left over from that time I filleted it. So I'm gonna get about 2 of those and put it in this. Thank you. right, we're gonna simmer this for about 20 minutes.
All right, now we're gonna make some rice.
We're gonna make about 2 cups of rice. Got the trusty old rice cooker. Had this for about 2-3 years and it's, you know, been doing its thing. All right, 2 cups of water. All right, we're gonna let this soak for about 20 minutes. All right, it's been about 20 minutes. Now we're gonna flip them. This is gonna be hard. Now we're gonna simmer for about 10 more minutes. All right, we're about to start this rice. Now I just wait. Got the cut out. Kuno? Kuno? Shinzo da yo? Shinzo. Hakuren no shinzo da yo? Kuu kana? Kuu de shou, kuu de shou, kuu de shou. Oishii? おいしいかな。もっとはないよ、もっとはない。はい、ただ慣れさせてだけ。はい、はい。OK、It's done。わあ。
Okay, let's get it. See, let's get some of this meat right here. All right, first we're gonna try some of this head meat. Mmm, yep, just like last time, super good. Mmm. Very good. Next, let's try some of this collar meat. Mmm! So good. So good. Alright, last, let's try some of this fillet. Mmm. Crystal のやつ。So good. These cucumbers are so good. Russian half sour pickles from the farmer's market. So good. Silver carp, Asian carp, whatever you want to call them, they're delicious. The head, tail, the belly, everything. It's all really good. So I recommend you also try it. Head to your local farmer's market. They're really cheap and you get a lot of meat. But yeah, thanks for watching all the way to the end. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye!